Hey everyone, here Link18 here, and welcome back to another episode of Terraria. In the last episode, we fought and killed the Eye of Cthulhu. Man, what was I even thinking when I... Okay, never mind. Point is, I killed the Eye of Cthulhu, and I also did a lot of stuff off camera. Now I have 380 health, and I only had, like, let's see, 240, I think, in the episode where we killed the Eye of Cthulhu. This is the underground jungle. Die, granite elemental. Here we are at the underground jungle. So, yeah, I'm pretty sure I just said that. I don't know. I have a terrible memory that a Seriously, Medusa? Seriously? No! I want to block off this lava. God. Yeah. Oh god, I need to find a safer place. Ooh, depth meter. Although we already have a depth meter, so there's no point in getting it. Okay, wait for that lava to... The heck? Why isn't the lava draining? Shouldn't the lava be draining? Okay, there, finally drained. What the? Seriously? I just get blown up. What? Oh my god, I just got blown up. Jesus Christ, now I have to go all the way back down there and... Who even put it there anyway? Like... Who would put... Like... What kind of person would be evil enough to... like... Literally hook up a pressure plate to some explosives with the intent of somebody stepping on them and blowing themselves up. Like, what kind of man would be evil enough to do that? Come to think of it, it probably wasn't a man. It was probably one of the, like, I don't know, undead miners. Basically, one of the enemies in this game. One of the enemies, hooked up a pressure plate to some explosives, so one of those pathetic fools, aka the humans, would come and step on them and blow themselves up, because every single enemy in this game hates humans, that's for sure. So I've got to get down here and make my way up here. Okay, get down here. Down to this lava lake thing. Grapple my way over here and then up here and then here and then here and then here and just grapple on. I don't know. Okay, make my way through the underground cabin. Ignore this big pit thing. Grapple my way up this hole. Make my way up this tunnel. Man, what was I thinking when I was mining before? Okay, make my way up to this marble cave. Grab my way up here. Let's see. Okay, so it's just like flowing lava. Flowing lava does not hurt you for whatever reason in this game. Here we go. Get into this mine car, ride the rails over to the underground jungle biome. We're getting pretty close to the point where we died. Okay. So I died somewhere around here. I'm pretty sure there's where I died. So, yeah, we're basically back on track now. So, yeah, are there gonna be any interesting things here? Oh, oh, oh! I almost killed myself by falling into the pit. Almost could have. Wow. Well, alright. So here's another crystal heart. And we're all maxed out now. We're, like, if we find any other crystal hearts along the way, oh, spiked jungle slime. Oh, gee! Seriously? That's so unfair. Yeah, kill yourself in the lava, you idiot. Oh, great, now I'm poisoned. But if we find any other crystal hearts during this let's play, we won't be able, like, I'm pretty sure that Dart Trap just missed me. Okay, here's the pressure plate. And here's the trap. Gonna get rid of both of them. And now we're gonna just keep mining. Yay, that's nice. Oh my god! Who? What kind of idiot would, like, what kind of idiot would place rails there? Right, now we're gonna have to build our way across that stupid gap of stupidness. Okay. Hey. Bridge cross here. It's getting pretty close to the underworld too. You can tell because of the lava veins in the background. Ooh, there's a hornet. Oh wow, that thing is an idiot. Why do hornets keep killing themselves? It's as if they want to die. Okay. Let me try to make sure that the lava doesn't fall on us. Okay, I'm gonna start digging. Oh wait, no, that wouldn't be safe either. My god. What am I even gonna do here? Yeah. Oh, don't mean to do that. Alright, over here. Wait. Okay. So, what's in this chest for us? A flow gun. 2 damage? Yeah, we are not taking that, although we're definitely taking this platinum and... Ooh, gravitation potion. These babies are awesome. Yeah, so... I think the way, bows and guns work is that, like... the weapon itself does an amount of damage, and the ammo does it an amount of damage, too. And, like... Basically, ooh, sharpening station. What should I throw away? What about this one piece of crinkling that... Oh, you're kidding me! Go away, jungle spores. But anyway, the way, guns and bows work is, that... That basically adds the damage of the weapon and the ammo. So yeah. Which means the flare gun would do like 3 damage. And that's terrible. Like, I'm pretty sure like the wooden bow does more than that. Much more than... Oh god, now I'm poisoned! Hey, go away! I don't want to deal with you. Let's see. What I think we should head home. Can we craft anything with these? Hold on, I got a message on Steam. Okay, so can we craft anything? Seriously? That's all we can craft? Is a platinum helmet? Seriously, that is expensive. That is really expensive. Do some more mining later on. Maybe I should go to the Crimson and see if I can take out the Brain of Cthulhu. Okay, so apparently, oh my god. So apparently there's no Crimson that way. So, we're gonna explore the unexplored areas. I wonder what's in store for us this way to the left. Off. Come on. Here we go. Over this hill. Ah, here's Crimson. So yeah, we should explore this area and make room for vicious mushrooms since they're used to... Oh, vile thorns. Crimson thorns. I'll break all of these. So, vicious mushrooms are required in making a boss summoning items, which is crucial to advancing in the game. Yikes. Face monsters. Those guys are creepy. The Crimson itself is creepy. Honestly, I think I prefer the Crimson to the Corruption, because, like, corruption, like, it only has, two enemies. That's the Eater of Souls and the Devourers. Primaris. These guys are, like, equivalent to the Eater of Souls. And there are a lot of them. What are they doing? That's kind of strange. Okay. Anything useful in this chest? Not really. We've got some torches. And I don't care about the shine potion. Okay. Jeez. Whoa, there's two of them. I didn't even realize they were traveling in, like, the exact same spot. 10 bars, that's useless, but I'll take it. Some grenades. Eh, we don't have any room for that. Umbrella. I'm just gonna replace it with the amethyst mining potion. Why not replace this with the crimson seeds? So let's go deeper into this chasm. There's a lot of chests here. Ooh, radar. I like radars. So yeah, gonna equip that. Screw it, we don't have room for all the rest. Here's the jungle. I don't care about the jungle, I just care about the crimson right now. There's a demon eye. Ooh, crimson altars. Later, after we defeat a boss called the Wall of Flesh, we get the Pwn Hammer, which, is strong enough to destroy these. If you try to destroy these with a hammer, like, it just takes away half your health. So you get a nasty shock, if you, try to beat it with something that's not the Pwn Hammer. Although, if you, do smash it with the Pwn Hammer, something good is bound to happen. So, in other words, your world gets blessed with, gets blessed with certain hard mode ores. Seriously, why are jungle signs? Let's see. I'm gonna try using bombs to blast my way through here so I can access the crimson. Oh, you're kidding me. Come on. Yeah, blow up. Seriously, that is a very, very small explosion. Okay, now I can get in here. Where's my hammer? There we go. Still have a wooden hammer. That's kind of pathetic, but... Ooh, meteorite. And... Hold on, let me light up this place. Ah, I got an Undertaker. Okay, I'm gonna make a mana crystal with these stars. So... Oh, Grimstone. Don't care about those. And... Oh, didn't mean to drink that. Not really hurt at all. And we got a bunch of musket balls too, which can be used with those things. Okay. I'm gonna try to get at this second, crimson heart. Flowers, since I hate them. And they hate me, I hate them. We both hate each other. All enemies hate everything. Almost everything in this game except for the NPCs hate me. There we go. So let's see what's in the second Crimson Heart. Oh my god! Those things just popped out of nowhere! Those things literally just came out of the walls! Okay, I'm gonna try to pick up this panic necklace. What it does is it lets you move faster whenever you get hit. So, okay, what should I replace with this? Screw it, how about the radar we just got earlier this episode? So let's test it out. See, panic. And we can move faster, so that's pretty cool. Allows us to perhaps run away better, I don't know. And the third Crimson Heart you break summons a boss, the Brain of Cthulhu, which I've actually never fought it before, like, so this Let's Play will be my first time ever, fighting the Brain of Cthulhu. Oh crap, a goblin army. That's probably how Coach Z speaks from a cartoon I watch on the internet called homestarrunner.com. But probably none of you know about that, I don't know. But we'll fight the goblin army later in this episode. Where's my magic mirror? Where is my... Okay, here it is. Goblin army is approaching from the west, and west is usually, the left, but, like, for whatever reason, the directions are reversed in this game. The sun, like, rises on the left and sets on the right. Meaning the goblin army is, somewhere around here. Oh crap, goblin army has arrived. So, we'll kill these. Oh wait, apparently it was from the left, okay. But anyway, I'm gonna, we'll kill these guys in the next episode, and I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, please don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscribe for more of my videos. And until the next video, this is HeroLink18 out.